Welcome to my channel. I'm so glad to see you today. And today I'm going to show you how I style my hair. Someone asked, and I think it's a very good idea. I pay attention a lot to my hair, and I think hairstyle, the way you brush, the way you style your hair is super important. I'm gonna show you how French women, Parisian women do their hair. I'm a little bit different than the, the classic. I'm not gonna say the classic because the way I style my hair are very classy, very classic. But you know, the cliche of the French, Parisian woman who like, you know, who have the messy, messy hair. Sometimes I do that. Actually, I love, you know, to do some type of messy style when I have a jean, when I wear jean. It's for a specific, I will say, fashion style or specific look, actually. But usually I like to do my hair in a very, very classy, very classic way because I'm an old school Parisian. I love vintage, I love old school things, I love classy things. For example, my icon, my French icon, for example, is Catherine Deneuve. I love Catherine Deneuve and I love how she did, her hair. It was very, very classy when she was young, for example. I love Brigitte Bardot. Brigitte Bardot also styled her hair in a certain way. So I love that type of thing. I don't like, it's not really my style, the very, very messy, very not well brushed hair. I like to do, in the classy way. So before also I start, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, but it gives me a lot of motivation. And you don't realize how happy I am when I saw all your comments or interaction, and when you ask new video, I really like it. So don't forget to subscribe. I post videos, I'm gonna post a lot of videos in the coming the next weeks. I try to keep it up, and I'm gonna post different type of video, hairstyle, cooking, French skincare, French lifestyle. So don't forget to subscribe, and you can also follow me on my Instagram because I love also to post a lot of things on Instagram about my lifestyle, how a Parisian woman live in the US, how I cook, how I style my hair. Also, I post a lot of things about my lifestyle. Before I'm gonna start, I did my makeup. So I did a very, very, very light makeup. Here in Miami, and because I'm taking the sun, I really stopped to wear foundation. I like the, in France, we really like, light makeup. We don't like things like very, contouring, all that stuff. It's not really our style. So French women don't wear a lot of makeup. We try to be very, very natural. And the way we use the makeup, it's also in that sense. Okay, we don't like to put a lot of foundation, etc. I used to put foundation, but unfortunately, because I had acne here in the United States, and I'm glad, my acne is over. Also because I'm taking the sun, and I did some French skincare routine, which really helped me with my acne here. But now, it's pretty the sun-kissed look I love, very light. I don't like to put so much makeup. So I'm gonna start. So I always put my French chouchou. We call it chouchou in France. I love it. It's from Alexandre Paris. So if the camera can zoom, it's Alexandre Paris. It's all, hair accessories. They're all made in France. They are very, very beautiful. This is, this is velvet, actually. I love velvet, and this one is so, so, so beautiful. So it's velvet. I love the color, and I think it's so, so classy, so chic, so elegant. So I really recommend you also this chouchou. You know why? Because also it's not gonna cut your hair, it's not gonna damage your hair when you attach, because most of the time when you attach your hair, you cut also when it's too tight. So this type of accessories, you know, they really respect the air. They're handmade in France and it's so, so beautiful. Look at how beautiful is it. So I also like to put some perfume on my chouchou actually. So it smells a perfume and I can have like a delicate smell of perfume in my hair actually. And I think it's so chic. So yeah, I love it. I love Alexandre accessories. I have also a pin actually, a pin very, very beautiful. But I love this chouchou. So I always wear my chouchou on my top, on top of my head. So you can, as you can see, I need to still style my hair, okay? But I can go, actually, you know what? I don't need to do a lot of things. I can even go out like that a little bit, you know? Just by, you know, putting some, you know, just using my hand, it's, I will say it's, it will be like the messy look. I don't need to do a lot of things today actually, but I'm gonna show you how I really want to style my hair, like when I, the way I like. But to be honest, I don't think I need to do a lot of things for my hair today, which is great. So I didn't brush anything as you can see, so I'm gonna use my brush. So I only use the Masson Pearson brush and I really recommend you this brush. So yeah, my Masson Pearson has like some age. I bought this brush six years ago actually. I was in New York and I was like, you know, I was hanging out in New York, I was doing some shopping and I needed a brush actually at that time. I didn't know anything about Masson Pearson brush. I didn't know it was like the best, the Rolls-Royce of a brush. They are super, super, you know, old brush, old brand. I didn't know nothing about the brush. I remember I was in a boutique in New York, probably, probably Upper West Side or Upper East Side. Anyway, I was in a big boutique in New York, Apothecary boutique, and I needed a brush. I saw this brush and I saw, you know, the really old vintage package, very, very nice. And I said, okay, I need a brush. It was expensive at that time, but I was like, okay, I need a big brush, big one. And I bought this brush and I went back home. And I realized, I made some research online and, you know, I realized that Masson and Pearson are the best brush you can buy actually out there. They are the best, so it's a very, very old English brand. So it's a very, very old British brand. It has been created more than one century, could you believe it? The brand has more than one century. Everything is made in England. Actually, you can also visit their boutique, museum, boutique collection in London, actually. Special about this brush is, so not only is the best brush, I mean, for long hair, I have very, very big curly hair. Actually, my hair are curly, you know, if they're like natural, they're gonna be curly. They are very big, I have a lot of volume, and usually it's painful when I brush my hair. They can broke. It's very, very painful. And this brush, Masson Pearson, they're really the best to respect, you know, if you have big, curly hair. They're the best for all type of hair, don't get me wrong. All type of hair, you can't go wrong. But what's so special about the brush, so at first everything is made in England, in London actually, but the bristle is handle and the rub cushion, so the rub cushion here, you know, the rub cushion, so you know, like that, as you can heard, and you know, it's flexible, so it's a rub cushion, and the rub cushion is also handmade, and it's, they have a patent for that. It's what really makes this you know, this brush so special. It's the rub cushion like that, which really, you know, protect the hair, also increase the, you know, the blood circulation on your scalp. It's really the best brush I ever had. And this brush has 6 years, but usually when you buy a Masson Pearson brush, you can have this brush for all your life. They are like, there is a guarantee, actually there's a life guarantee for this brush. because it's such a good, good quality. They're like the best of the best. And usually you keep, not usually, but you keep this brush for like probably all your life. And it's a, you know, it's a, like, it's such a old brand, vintage brand. Probably maybe your grandma know the brand, your grandma. They have over 1 century of history. They have been on the market 1 century and 30 years. Could you believe it? 1 century and 30 years. And they're still on the market and it's the best of the best. This is the best brush. So I recommend if you really love your hair, if you like, you know, if you're someone who like think like me that hairstyle is important, I recommend to really invest into a Mason Buesen brush. It's an investment because it's a little bit expensive. But it's really a long time investment, a long term investment. You're not gonna buy 20 different brush, you just need one. You can use also this one on wet hair, even it's not made for that, but it's such a good brush, actually such a good quality brush that you can also use this one when your hair are still wet, because it's still very respectful to the hair. What I'm gonna say, yeah, so it's my brush is still here, and what I like about this old brand like that, you know, there's such history behind it, and it's a beautiful brush. Correctly, there's different type of brush. I think I got the medium size and B2. I'm not sure, I need to check. I will put in the comment when I will check later. Yeah, I think it's a B2 one. They have different type of brush. I recommend to go to their website, and there's an area where you can put some information and you can choose according to the information you're gonna say, the kind of brush which really is gonna fit really your type of hair, the best brush for you. They're gonna make some suggestion or recommendation. So I recommend also to check their website. They explain everything. But I think I got the B2, which is a mix of a nylon and a natural bristle. So there's a mix of the two, and the size is probably medium. I don't take the big one, but the size is medium. This is the perfect brush for long hair, middle long hair, and thick curly voluminous hair also. They also work on thin hair, I think, but there's another brush for thin hair. But I will recommend, yeah, try their website, go to their website, put your hair information, and they're gonna give you some suggestion or recommendation which brush is the best for you. I don't need to do a lot of things actually, but I'm gonna show you how I style correctly. What you need? Elnett, L'Oreal Elnett spray. I love Elnett spray. L'Oreal are the best, and it's very Parisian. We always use L'Oreal. I don't go for a very expensive one. I think L'Oreal is great. You know, it's such a good brand, and I love the Elnett spray. It's the best. And it's something I also buy here in Miami to my French hairdresser in Miami, actually. It's called 7-Second Glossing. I love glossing. I used to buy a few years ago a glossing from a very French old brand, and unfortunately it's discontinued. I think it was Berdoux. Berdoux is also a very old eau de cologne, a very old French eau de cologne. I don't know if you know them, but if you go to Paris, they sell Berdoux everywhere. You're gonna find Berdoux everywhere, basically. I have some bottle at home in Paris. It's called Berdoux. It's a very old perfume eau de cologne. They do perfume and eau de cologne, but they start first as eau de cologne. I think they start in 1904. So as you can see, it's very old brand, and they used to do a glossing. I love glossing at the end of my hair because it gives this nice touch. It moisturizes the hair. It gives some glossing look. I really like it. It's very chic. So unfortunately, this continue, and I found this one on the, in my French hairdresser in Miami. It's called Unit, and I love this one because it smells so, so good. You know, I love perfume. I love smelling good, and it smells a little bit of neroli, orange blossom. I love neroli. I really, really love neroli. I love orange blossom, and it smells super, super good. So I really also recommend this one. So let's start. So first I'm gonna brush a little bit my hair because I didn't brush it. So how I brush it, I brush in the very traditional traditional way. My French hairdresser told me to brush like that. So when you brush your hair, you should brush also the scalp, especially with this brush, because it's really like, it really activates the circulation, the scalp circulation. It's really good for the hair. And you can see how my hair looks like. When I brush with this brush, my hair looks like silk. I swear, this brush, like... If you don't know this brush, go for it. Look how my hair looks now. They look like silk, silk, silk. And I don't need to do a lot of things, actually. You know, I can go out like that. I can go out like that, like I don't need to do like a lot, basically. Yeah, you see how I don't need, you know. Here will be very nice because it's not too styly, it's not too much, it's not, it will be the perfect Parisian chic way to style my hair, actually. Yeah, I don't need to do a lot of things, but I'm gonna show you how I style usually my hair. So I can go out like that. It will be, you know, super, because it's not too much, it's not too styled. Actually, it's not too styled. It can work like that, you know, just by brushing that. But I'm gonna show you how I style my hair usually. So I use an iron strafer. So I'm gonna start. I usually divide it like that. Okay, I divide, and I'm gonna start by the bottom. Actually, I'm gonna start here. Okay. So let's see. So I do some curl like that, okay? I do some curl, and I'm gonna show you how I work the curl. So it's not like perfect, it's not perfect. It's gonna be the, you know, the Parisian chic look, not too perfect. So usually I go to my French hairdresser once a week. I really like to go to the hairdresser, to be honest, because my hair are like curly, they're not easy to manage, actually. And you know, hairdresser for a French woman, it's really important. I don't know a French woman who don't like to go to the hairdresser, actually. I don't know one. I go once a week. Usually Parisian, I know some Parisian who go once a week. Some of them go only to do the, you know, the highlight, actually. I go once a week. Now I'm gonna separate. I don't use anything, it's very like, there's not a lot of method in the way I style my hair, but I know what I'm doing. Like that, you see? So let me show you correctly how I do it. So you take, I learned that years ago, so now for me it's very easy to do it. So I take like that, I pinch, I turn, and I like to curl at the end, not to curl all the band, all it, just to curl a little bit at the end. You see? Just to curl a little bit at the end. Pinch, you turn like that, and you turn like that. You see? I learned that years ago. It wasn't easy when I first started. And now it's very, look, you see, I can do that like in few minutes now I can do it. So usually it's the way I do, I style it. You turn a little bit and you curl at the end. So at the end, I really curl more at the end. And it gives, you know, this kind of like chic Parisian look. It's very Catherine Deneuve. If you don't know Catherine Deneuve, Google it. Go to Pinterest. Or you can go to my Instagram. You're gonna see a lot of like a picture of Catherine Deneuve because I love Catherine Deneuve. And the way she styled her hair was a little bit like that, actually. It's very Catherine Deneuve. Brigitte Bardot also. She do a lot of curl like that, okay? But it's probably Brigitte Bardot is more messy, okay? More messy way. Beachy look. She has a more beachy look, Brigitte Bardot, actually. But I, for now, I style it like that. I love also beachy look. I used to also do it with like beach spray. I love it also. I think it's also very chic. But currently, I don't know. I'm like, I like the way I'm doing right now. You know, I like it. I think it's, yeah. It's very chic, very my style. But you can do it in a different way, for sure. So you see, but it's not finished. Là, it's just, you know, it's not finished. It's just the way I do it. I curl and I really curl at the end, okay? I'm gonna do the other side. So the other side, I'm gonna do in the other way, okay? Because I want it to be like that, okay? I want the chic look. So I pinch and I turn. I pinch and I turn. Like that. And I curl in the other way. You see? You see how it does? It's not finished. It's not finished. This is just the way, the first step of curling. And I don't like to curl all the way. Okay. Yeah. So usually I also put a protector. I didn't do it, but usually I put a spray. I like to put the Oribe. The Oribe spray, anti humidity Oribe spray, just before. It's a French dresser who told me that. She told me like, okay, you can put a spray just before so it protects the air against, you know, the temperature. So usually you put something before. I didn't do it. And the temperature of my iron is not very high. I don't put high temperature because first I'm blonde. So my hair very like also already fragile, you know, very fragile because of the decoloration and the bleach and everything. But I recommend to put a spray before. Alors also I use GHD, okay? Usually my iron, this one is like Remington, actually this one is Remington, but I usually use GHD. In Paris I have GHD, okay? GHD. my hairdresser, my French hairdresser, recommend me this brand. He told me, yeah, it's best for the hair, doesn't lead to any breakage. Go for GHD, he told me. So, but here in America, I didn't bring with me GHD. And but Remington is a very good brand. I recommend this one. I buy this one on Amazon, and frankly, I'm very surprised. It's a very good one, and for the price, it's not expensive at all. I think I got this one for like $40 max, and this one is very, very good. It do beautiful, beautiful curl, and it's, I don't have a lot of breakage with my hair actually, so I'm very, very pleased. This is it. This is like that. So this is like I curl a little bit. I curl so it's more like, and now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rebrush it a little bit so it's more natural. Don't forget that French women, we like natural, we love the natural look actually. So even it's more chic, more, you know, it's chic for sure. Like my hair are very, you know, they're very style in a very chic way. It's very Catherine Deneuve. I want to be more like, you know, more natural. So I'm gonna, you know, I'm gonna work now with my hands. So, yeah, I'm gonna work with my hands. I think my hair needs a little bit of moisturizer. I can feel it because I saw some breakage, you know, when I brush them. You know, and they're so blonde. Now they're very, very blonde. So I need to be a little bit more careful now. I love Leonor Grey product actually. They're very, very good, especially on a very, you know, very damaged or like dehydrated hair actually. They prevent breakage. So now I'm working on that. So yeah, I should have put the spray before, but that's okay. So usually I put the spray before, so you see now it's like it's more natural. It gives this natural way to, so I like to brush to just detangle the curl, just to make it more like, I don't know, it gives more like volume, yeah, and I work with my hands, okay? And to finish, I use two things. So I use the glossing spray. Mm, it smells so good. So you really, you know, it hydrates a little bit the hair, and it gives this, and especially on blonde, this one is so, so good on blonde. It gives some shiny touch on the hair. It's, and the silk. Frankly, my hair like silk. I can feel my hair like silky actually. They're like silk. Yeah, right now they like silk. And I finish with some Elnett satin spray because here in Miami there's a lot of humidity, and my brushes is not gonna last long. My curl, they're not gonna last long if I don't put some kind of like lac. We call it lac in French. Some kind of spray like that. So it's my final touch is the Elnett satin. I love this one because also it does not, you know, it does not make your hair super sticky. Just, you know, just to brush it to remove the spray, the Elnett. Elnett for me is the best, and you find, you know, in Paris you find Elnett everywhere. You go to Monoprix, you go to every little drugstores or shop, or like they sell Elnett everywhere. Here in America it's very weird. Where I am in Miami, I had to do few CVS or Target to find one Elnett. They don't sell that easily. It's very, very weird because in France it's super common. Everybody use Elnett. I know even a guy or men who use Elnett. They also use Elnett to really work on the hair. And it's wonderful because, yeah, there's no sticky touch, sticky, you know, sometimes some spray give you this sticky touch and it's not very chic at all. You can really see that it's super sticky, to like, you know, super carton, like it's very like wear. This one it does not. It's very, very natural, but it works very well on humidity. I can tell that if I forget to add my Elnett spray, my curl won't be like, they won't stay that long, especially with very humid humid weather in Miami. So you see, I'm ready. I'm gonna see on the camera more. So now I'm ready. It's how I style my hair, you know, when I'm doing some videos. I like to style it like that. It's very, very, like I said, very classy Parisian style. My mom and my grandmother, they also used to style a little bit like that. Maybe it was shorter, so it's a very classy way in Paris to style. There's also, you know, the messy, beachy, very messy Parisian way to style also. I can do that. It's happening also, depending of my style, of how I look, how I dress. But I like this way, because this way, I think it's chic, it's classy. It's very chic, very classy. I like it, and like I said, it's very, very Brigitte Bardot, Catherine Deneuve. Very Catherine Deneuve, actually, when she was young. It was her way to style it. And I try to let my hair grow, which is a little bit difficult, because when you got blonde, usually you have a lot of breakage, and it's not easy to let them grow. The little bit also damaged because of the, you know, the sun, the beach, probably also, you know, the fact that they're super blonde. I wasn't that blonde one few months ago. I get blonder and blonder because of the sun and the beach, but I really like it. I really like it. So that's the way, you know, classy Parisian woman like to style their hair. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and I'm gonna see you for another video. I wish you a very, very good day, and don't forget to wear perfume. Bye.